she was so busy that we knew Molly was gonna suffer before we could get somebody before she could come out because of the schedule. And so I can't remember her name, but she was wonderful too. They're just about it.
They're something that they want to stay together.
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping. Well, honestly, with stuff like this, it's less work than if you just took one of them.
Right.
They have built in place.
They're great to go.
Too, but I mean, I went a whole day before and I had rewrite six. So yes, I say.
But, you know, when it works, it works. I actually found that the more dogs we have, the easier it was for anyone. It shifts the, you don't get that on top dog.
The dynamic totally changes.
Right, from two to three, yes.
But then after that, it's like as easy as.
A buddy of mine, that went to our middle school and school together, they've got anywhere between 10 to 15 dogs at any time. They have a habit of taking in STR dogs from pack. Dogs that are like, they're gonna put them down. Straight to rescue. So there are dogs that can no longer stay in the shelter. Yeah, well, so he takes dogs that like can only, you know, can't live with any other dogs, and he brings them home and introduces them right to the pack. And I think the input is when a dog comes in and they're kind of jerky,
right?
There's an entire pack of other dogs. You can't really like, come in, and what are you gonna do, fight a buddy? You know, like, so they kind of dial the behavior back
immediately.
And, yeah,
exactly.
And they have, he generally has a couple scuffles, but. It's the ones that have been there the longest that, like, they know, telling this is how we do it here. Mm-hmm. And within days, everything is just, they don't crate, they don't, you know, it's just, okay. They all live together on, like, 3 or 5 acres. And he put in this huge, swimming pool.
Oh.
That, like, awesome. Most of it's, like, 3 feet.
Yeah.
Because they also, he's like a jelly bean guy, he's like 6'6". Huge guy.
So it's built for the dog.
Dude, oh, yeah, totally for the dogs.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's a lot of
Yeah.
But that's what they do. They bring home the old broken dogs.
Not all dogs. Water dogs.
Yeah. Most dogs. Oh, yeah. He sits on a chair in the pool. You know, he said they chuck it.
Yeah.
It kind of falls into the pool. And they all, you know. That's
really good. I have a funny story on a husky. I mixed a Kika husky that I adapted. And escape party. And I got her home and she went right over the wall and I was like, 5 feet, no problem. And she would do it all the time and I kept having to go out and find her, and then she realized it was a game. So then she'd be out like 3 hours and then sometimes I'd lose her, couldn't find her. But when she would get hot, she'd go jump somebody's wall that had a pool. Because she'd come back wet, or I'd find her wet. I'm like, oh dear Lord. And one day she was plenty wet, and I realized she got down to the Santa Cruz. And so I was like, oh, it was awful. But anyways, one day I was walking her through the neighborhood, and this car is slowly going by me, and I was like, that's always creepy, right?
Right.
And I look, and they're like, hi, excuse me, Joe. Isn't that your dog who's been in our pool? And I'd just be like, so embarrassed.
So sorry.
Like, yep. I'm like, oh. Yeah, sorry, she had this issue with jumping my wall. But I then had to figure out what to do because nothing I put near the fence, noisemakers, nothing worked for her. So eventually I would have her on a long lead and I would be there in the yard while she was on the motor in that field. So she was never outside without her. And that kept her in. Until she got older and couldn't jump the wall anymore.
There's some who had that old age thing.
Yeah. But
well,
she,
I know. I
took her to a therapy dog and went to the hospital together and visited patients. That was fun.
Yeah.
The Humane Society's program. Yeah. So a pet VIP.
Right. Yeah. That's great. No, I know. I've got a couple of friends that have installed
electric.
No, the coyote rollers. Tops. So. There's a really simple way to do it. I mean, you can hire a fencing company and stuff, but they're gonna charge an arm and a leg. But you get the brackets, and it's basically what you can do, like tight cable, and you run the cable through the snake. And so when they jump, so the idea behind it, how it came to be, was when coyotes would try to jump the wall, they would hit this, and they can't get over because they can't get. You know,
got
it just spins.
Interesting.
But it works the other way around too, where the dogs.
My neighbors
would have
hated me because we share the wall. So
So my back fence is like a view fence, it's iron. The side walls are the block, and she chose that because she could land on the top. So she'd find someone else who had, you know, we had a choice of iron or block in the back. I wanted to see the building, so I chose iron.
Right.
So she would go ba-bum, ba-bum, and then over somebody's that had block going out to the door. Oh my gosh! So hard.
Well, that's the problem with them, they're smart.
Yeah, she's. Well, that's with him too. He's very intelligent. Yeah, he picks things up really quickly.
I know, I wish he worked out with me.
Wasn't that long ago she went out, but she's.
It would be interesting to see him more with, you know, other dogs. And if he's that way.
And you took her just such a long walk.
Yeah.
Some dogs are reactive with just certain dogs.
So the way that he acted today is what it sounded like he was doing when he first went into the play yard. And then he said to initiate and engage in play. So it's one of the things here, just like at Long Pond, is that we don't have an enclosed space.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm looking forward to in the next store.
If the next home for him is a solo dog home, maybe good too. But if the next home has a dog, I would say dump dog.
Right. Yeah.
Because the matches play like
anything. Right. Absolutely.
He'd be too much for Marley. Yeah, because it was good for me to see Marley too and how.
Oh, yeah. That'll help you.
Yes. Right.
That'll help you as far as, you know, trying to. Because I think she's got a minimal energy from what I saw.
Very soft.
Dogs and Jonas. She's still around and she loves.
Yeah. So Sophia is the.
Yeah.
Closet.
I'm in my other car, but I have some stuff in the back. Do you need any shelves or anything to set it up?
Not right now. No. Well, let me try another number. Oh, but she didn't answer that number. Let's try this number. It's the same. It's coming to the same place.
Try though.
We don't know.
Oh, you don't know.
Yeah, we're kind of at their mercy because they're. Yeah, I think so. I don't expect.
Help decorating.
Well, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't have tons of free time, but I could throw in definitely a couple.
Yeah, I don't. It's going to depend on how long it takes for them to get the on the asbestos.
Gotcha.
So it was either the mastic or the tile itself, or the original.
What was the
age they put? Oh God, that place has been there forever. Yeah.
Wonder.
Well, when we were looking at it, I called because we walked with the property manager about almost 2 months ago now. And it was under multiple other layers of flooring, but because it's worn down and
removed,
that's exactly it. Well, that's actually what they did in commercial properties, because as long as it wasn't disturbed, you were fine.
Yeah.
It's when it gets disturbed and then there's dust, that's when the particles in the air get, and that's what gets in the animals. Right. So.
Remember when they came out with that fake wood flooring?
Lumber liquidator got saved for that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully they're not making any more of that.
It was all from China.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
Well, maybe
what was it, Melamine, in their baby farm?
That's what
they used to. What
time is it?
Like, really? Yeah. But they get away with it.
1:34.
12:45. Yeah, well,
it's almost an hour.
Well, I'll keep you. You never know.
I mean, we do have different dogs that, you know, that come in all the time. And I do like to keep the same ones unless, like, I'll bring Fletcher back to see if the behavior is still at that level. And I just want to leave. But generally, unless they adopt for foster, they'll continue to come back. I chose to bring him because I knew that we would be able to help out here.
Yep.
You know, so even though it was some, so that's how sometimes that happens around here. It's a happy accident.
Yeah, he needs it. He's ready.
Well, immediately
just
start
so much
for him.
Immediately start moving.
Right.
Get his focus close here and
right.
Versus just the dog there.
Yeah. Yeah. That's the thing, like, he's right there, he's making progress, so, you know, I know when he needs it.
Creed?
No. Creed. It's just a game.
Stop. When did he start that?
From the beginning.
He actually better than he was.
Yeah, he was obnoxious before.
My thought was him to get him out of his mouth.
Really?
My gray one is.
I have a purple stain on it.
Yeah, I've gotta get another design.
Gina's out there on Sunday, she probably does another 10.
I think, I think she might be, I don't know if she's in town, I, she posted something last week, because she was on vacation with her mom. But that might have just been a couple days, I don't know.
What are you doing?
I got back on Facebook only because.
What are you doing?
I hate it.
What's your belly full?
But I have to be on every day, because it doesn't really matter at all.
Sure.
And it's free to edit, so, yep. I mean, unless you consider what costs you in peace of mind, but otherwise, it's free. Doesn't cost me any money, so, yeah.
All right, well, thanks for trying. He's gonna be, like I said, if he goes to the right person or people that are them, it's not gonna take a lot.
Yeah.
It's really not, he just needs consistency.
Yeah, exactly, that's a strong handler.
And somebody that's gonna be consistent with boundaries, because he knows, he does things when others that he doesn't do.
They allow his work, so it's great.
Give them, you know, that's the other reason why I bring dogs that came up here, because I'll say to people, you know, this is not the right dog for you, and here's why.
Yep.
You know?
Perfect.
Yeah.
I noticed the last time I went to pet, that they were, we did that now.
Well, because, you know why?
Thank God.
So, when I was there, when I was running the dog adoption program, it was our lowest rate of return that happened to see. And since they had paid adoption camps, I was doing the adoption. And when I left, they returned their returns to me. Because they were concentrating on nothing but just getting dogs out, just setting out. I oversaw the dog adoption program. So, they saw that the rate of return of dogs were just, they were outrageous. Well, because you were just, your whole thing was just numbers, just getting out. That's all you cared about. You were just sending dogs out with more people, letting them bring the same thing out. What I learned, so
that's what I like so much, that that's changed.
Yeah, well, one of the ladies that worked with me, when I was there, I loved to watch her do intro. She would be walk the yard, and then she would be telling them what she was seeing. And so she knew within 10 seconds of being in the yard if this was a good idea or not. But what she would do is she would steer them to the no, if that's what she wanted. Because what we found was if you told somebody no, then there could be 3,000 dogs on property. And I want that dog that you told me I can't have. Become just like a dog,
hyper-focused.
Yeah. So that's what I'm doing. Like, if we're doing really, really little dog, and I can see, and the person's like, oh, it'll be fine, they'll work through it. And I'm like, okay, well, do you see, like, when your dog does this, this is how this dog reacts. And sort of try to steer them to seeing it themselves.
Yep.
Because if they see it themselves and they make that decision, that's important. So, it usually works.
How many years do you get?
In that particular position, about a little over 2. Yeah. I was on staff at that time. Involved in something else. A lot of stuff. Yeah.
I would be in and out
all the time. Oh, yeah, at the end of the day, they still have to get dogs out.
But you got to find that happy medium.
There's a better place than just sending out the door and that's what. Because that's the thing, if a dog like him goes out to the wrong person and comes back with behavior problems, now I can't bring him here. So that's why I'm really careful about the way I send him.
The whole dog system on that one.
Right, on that one.
Yeah.
So that's kind of how I see our role has changed a lot, not just focusing on finding your adopters, but I'm as happy to get out from the foster or just to simply have them here. Like Lily has completely come out of her shell when she first got up here. She didn't interact with anybody. And now she comes to the kennel and she, well, and the thing is, if they come to the kennel here, they're going to do it at pack.
that's what gets them out. So if we can get them to that place, and it gives them a break, but they need to get back in there too.
Do you have somebody in that, because we, they go in there, that's sure these dogs are, if you, if you.
Well, there's.
Do these dogs?
No, if they're walking through, the kennels, there's, like, for example, their kennel today is empty, and, but, so their paperwork, just like what's hanging here, exactly the same.
I'm at TRN today, come to visit me.
And there's a thing that says, I'm at TRN, and it gives our address and hours and everything, so, yeah, that is there.
Oh, good, good, at least there's that.
Yeah, so they put those cards in the mornings when they pull the dogs.
Have you had people come up?
Oh, yeah, I've had, that's how, yeah, yeah. The last one.
So, social media, that, and what, do, are you on any of those, how do you handle those?
No, that's pretty much it. The problem with that is that, other than just to advertise in general, but to put specific stuff in, by the time it goes to print, 9 times out of 10, none of those dogs are available. Yeah, that's what I mean, it was just a general thing, just like that.
What other stuff do they get to, raise to the night rockets, the smaller rescue, right?
They don't, Friends of PAC, this is the first time they've done this. We're doing this because it's me, because there's